Hello, everybody. Happy Friday. I hope everybody is doing well. So this week we spoke or read a lot on leftist ideologies and in education and interpretive trends in history. And I'm going to kind of take my progressivism as Marxism and apply it to this week's conversation. By doing so, I'm going to look at three different books that I found in the Project Muse database. And I'm going to focus on a gentleman named Richard T. Ely, who was considered the father of progressivism. The first piece I chose was by Thomas C. Leonard, which I've actually read before, called Illiberal Reformers: Race, Eugenics, and American Economics in the Progressive Era. And the parts that focus upon Ely, because he's a prominent character in the progressive era and progressivism in general, is his attendance of graduate school in Germany at the German Historical School. And he was taught basically German socialism, or what they called socialist of the lectern. When he would come back to the States, he would be pivotal in implementing what the German statism and socialist model, the progressives would call the administrative state, which is a direct descendant of the socialists of the lectern. In fact, Princeton's Frank Fetter in 1925, at occasion honoring Ely, that in the history of scholarship, there could not be found a higher average of success and achievement than this little band of pioneers attained. And that's going to be the theme here, is where does this leftward bend in education begin? You can see it here early in the progressive era. Between 1880 and 1900 is what they consider a revolution in higher education. Ely and his band of pioneers taught and led German-style research seminars. They granted PhDs, and they wrote as specialists for each other in over a half dozen scholarly journals, which they founded and edited. They taught that industrial capitalism required continuous supervision, investigation, and regulation. Basically, that a nation is an organism and is greater than the sum of individuals. This first generation of academic progressives created two new American vocations: the professor of economics and the expert economist in the service of the administrative state. For the next piece that I chose by Benjamin Rader, The Academic Mind and Reform: The Influence of Richard T. Ely in the American Life, this is from 2015. Leonard's book was from 2016. Some of the information I gleaned from this piece was that relates to our conversation was that by 1937, Ely had sold nearly a million copies of textbooks, second only to economic works to Adam Smith's Wealth of Nations. That's a big deal. Ely's books were used in over 250 universities and colleges in the 1920s. In 1885, 31-year-old John Hopkins University professor Richard T. Ely stated that progressives should organize for the purpose of issuing a proclamation of emancipation from classical economics. Our third piece was written by Lenore Ely and Stephen Ely, and it's titled Progressivism and Philanthropy. And this is from a publication called The Good Society. And I have a short quote I pulled from them relating to how deep the left and Marxist ideology is, and where it began with the progressives. And I quote, "Social control was a new concept that described the ability of social mechanisms to shape the values and actions of individuals on behalf of the collective." Early sociologist E.A. Ross wrote that the system of control, like the education system, is charged not with revisiting the structure of functions of society, but with the shaping of individuals. And indeed, this is where we can look at and sort of pinpoint where these ideologies began and took over the education system moving forward even to today. Thank you guys. I hope everybody has a great weekend.